The legal fight led by the NAACP has been an astonishing success. But its very success shows the limitations of law and law enforcement unless this program has an economic foundation. Unless the mass of Negro people have not simply legal rights, but have such rights to work and wage that enable them to live decently. Here in the United States, we have had a stirring of the Negro population which emphasizes these facts. In the slave South, Negroes impoverished and mistreated have sought remedy by pouring into the cities of the South and especially into the great cities of the North. They have caused problems of housing and of crime, of poverty and disease. It spells the damnation of youth and death of children and degradation of women. Through this, the American Negro is passing. It emphasizes our national problem of gambling and prostitution, drug using and murder and suicide. On the other hand, the Negroes who have grown in intelligence and awareness of their handicaps have begun to fight back by the use of the boycott and the passive resistance, the experience in Montgomery, the extraordinary uprising of the students all over the South and beginning in the North shows an awareness of our situation which is most encouraging. But it still does not reach the center of the problem. And that center is not simply the right of Americans to spend their money as they wish and according to law, but the chance for American Negroes to have money to spend because of employment by which they can make a decent wage. What then is the next step? It is for American Negroes in increasing numbers and more widely to insist upon the legal rights which are already theirs, and then to add to that, increasingly a socialistic form of government, an insistence upon the welfare state which denies the further carrying out of industry for the profit of those corporations which monopolize wealth and power. The stopping of a government of wealth, for wealth, and for wealth, and the returning of governmental power to the individual voter with all the freedom of action that can be preserved, along with an industry carefully organized for the good of the masses of people and not for the manufacture of millionaires. Does capitalism offer such a program? It does not. It offers war. We have gone in